In this problem, you are investing a total of $27,000 in two accounts. One account pays 2% simple interest and the other pays 3% simple interest. So let's remember the simple interest formula. I equals PRT, where I equals the interest earned, P equals the principal, or you can think of it as what you invest. R is the rate, and T is time in years. So at the end of the 5 years, your total return, or your total interest earned, is $3,425. How much did you invest in each account? So I like to set up a table to organize my information. So I'm going to use those variables to start my table. So we have an account that pays 2% simple interest. So under the R column for one row, I'm going to put 0.02 because that's 2% as a decimal. And the other account is 3% interest. So as a decimal, that'll be 0.03. This is at the end of 5 years. So T would be 5 for each scenario. Now the question is, how much did you invest in each account? So those are unknown values, so we're going to use variables to represent that. So let's use X for the amount that we invested in the 2% account and Y for the amount that we invested for the 3% account. Now you invested a total of $27,000. So if we were to take the principal column and add that up, that would be 27,000. So this is going to give us one equation in our system of equations, but we need to get the other one from the interest earned column. So we need to put some values in that column. So remember that I equals P times R times T. So if I take 5 times 0.02 times X, that would give me 0.1X. And then I'll do the same thing for the 3% interest row. 5 times 0.03 times Y will give me 0.15Y. And so that the total return, or the total amount of interest that I earned, was $3,425. So now I have my equations for my system. The yellow equation will be 0.1x plus 0.15y equals $3,425. Then the blue equation will be x plus y equals $27,000. And so now we'll solve this system of equations. So I'm going to use the substitution method. So I'm going to take the second equation and solve for x. And as you can see, it really doesn't matter which variable you solve for because you would do the same step for either one. So I'm just going to solve for x. So if I solve for x, I have to subtract y on both sides. So I have x equals 27,000 minus y. So I'm going to take that in red and plug it in for x in the other equation. So it'll be 0.1 times 27,000 minus y plus 0.15y equals 3,425. Now I'm going to distribute 0.1 with 27,000, which will give me 2,700, and then 0.1 times negative y will be negative 0.1y, and then bring down that plus 0.15y equals 3,425. So now I'm going to combine like terms. So negative 0.1 plus 0.15 is going to give me 0.05y. Bring down 2,700 plus 0.05y equals 3,425. I'm solving for y, so I'm going to subtract 2,700. So I have 0.05y equals 3,425 minus 2,700 equals 725. And then to solve for y, I'm going to divide by 0.05, which is going to give me y equals 14,500. So that's half of my answer. I want to solve for x now. So I'm going to take this y and plug it in for y into the other equation. So I have x equals 27,000 minus 14,500, and 27,000 minus 14,500 is going to give me 12,500. So I've got two numbers, but I have to remember what these numbers represent. So if I go back to my table, x represented the amount invested in the 2% interest account. So you invested 12,500 into the 2% interest account. And then the 3% interest account, you invested $14,500. And the two of them added together gives you that total investment of $27,000.